When the hurricane season comes, Haiti is often first in line. Here, a United Nations team is meeting an emergency session as a hurricane threatens the island. They're making preparations for the vulnerable. These are emergency shelters, places where people will be evacuated to. A church will suffice. They're places the vulnerable will find shelter as the gales sweep across the country, because so many people are living in flimsy tents, shelters, or very weak structures. It could be a school, because that would provide shelter for the young, the elderly, and the vulnerable. Much of Haiti has been devastated by deforestation as poor, hungry people eke out a living. The result is more poverty as the country's soil gets washed into the sea, causing flooding and hunger, while pushing ever more poor people into overcrowded city slums.
If we clean up back there tomorrow.
Stefan Italian is a community leader in City Salai, which is right at sea level, and behind him the canal Saint George is full of rubbish. And it's a real impediment to the development of this poor community. This young volunteer is asking for pickaxes, shovels, anything, he says, anything to help us clear out this garbage. In fact, they need much more than that. They need heavy lifting equipment. They need dredging. They've had some of that, thanks to the International Organization for Migration. But the garbage keeps on coming. It keeps flooding. It keeps threatening ruin on this community. Here a local community is fighting back. Volunteers, every one of them. They're planting trees. This is where hope is starting again in Haiti.
Moi c'est Bigo Israël. Mon ça va regarder notre bois, lui c'est Mon Saint-Gérard. Alors on a 8e section communale de Petit Bois. Nous j'étais ensemble, nous ouais.
He says that the past 5 years have brought great improvements. The locals harvest wood sustainably, and with money earned, they can now send children to school to learn new trades. Workers at this nursery grow many varieties of fruit and forest trees for food, lumber, and fuel. Over 1 million trees have been planted so far, and the community says they can already see the difference. The nursery and the reforestation of the region all have long-lasting impact. Since this community started collaborating with the International Organization for Migration, or IOM, they say flooding has been reduced. Improved irrigation canals for farmers and roads for market sellers and consumers have brought more food into more hands in the area. Okay. The trees are already thriving. Through reforestation, with emergency shelters, better organization at government level and canals that are properly maintained, the country can prepare for the worst and defend against the hurricanes that regularly come sweeping in across the Caribbean.